Hello, this is Gano 136 here with Lieutenant Commander Desmond James from NORAD Public Affairs here to answer a couple of your NORAD Trek Santa questions. Welcome, Lieutenant Commander.
Thanks for having me.
Well, when this program has started many years ago, please tell our people viewing this how the tradition of tracking Santa actually started.
Yeah, absolutely. I love telling this story because it predates NORAD. NORAD stood up in 1958. But the tracking Santa program actually started in 1955 with an organization called CONAD, the Continental Air Defense Command. What happened was in Colorado Springs, where we are, there was a local business put an ad in a local paper asking kids to call this number and they will tell you where Santa Claus is. Unfortunately for the business, but fortunately for NORAD, the phone number went to the phone of Colonel Harry Shope. It went to his red phone, and the red phone, when that rings, it's either the president or the Pentagon, the four-star calling. So on the 24th of December in 1955, the phone rang. Colonel Harry Shope picked it up and said, "Yes, sir." And there was a little kid on there who said, "Do you know where Santa Claus is?" And he didn't know what was going on. And then the phones were ringing, and he quickly figured out something's wrong. However, all these kids are calling, and we are going to tell them where Santa Claus is. So he directed all of his staff to take all those phone calls that day, tell them all where Santa Claus is, and that started the tradition back in 1955. NORAD stood up in 1955, and we picked up that tradition, and we've been doing it now for altogether 56 years.
All right, and I also love hearing that story every time. It's it just shows how far back this predates. What has changed through the years through the NORAD Trek Santa program?
You know, we originally just used to use phone calls, and back in 1998, we moved on to the internet so that we could push the information out to people rather than just having them call us in on the phone lines. Then we've added email. We started using social media back in 2009, and it's really expanded since it started, even on the internet back in 1998. And to give you an idea of how big it's really gotten, excuse me, last year we answered almost 80,500 calls in the NORAD Track Santa Operations Center, and that's from 1,200 volunteers who come in and answer phone calls. So that was a whole lot of phone calls. It was probably the most we've ever had. And then we had more than 7,000 emails that came in on the website. We had nearly 15,500,000 visitors came to the website. That was from 227 countries around the world. Facebook, we ended up topping 715,000 fans. 53,000 people followed on Twitter. It's really grown. And this year, we are well over 740,000 fans already.
And how has the response been for the Internet Trivia Contest for the Facebook social media this year?
Oh, it's been great. You know, we were sitting around saying, you know, Facebook's a whole lot of fun to get people interacting. How can we, you know, for people's time, how can we give them back something? So we came up with this trivia idea, and it's been far more, the response has been far more than we expected. We've hundreds of people respond to each question, and literally around the world. So we've had prize winners in England, in Ireland, we've had them all around the U.S., we've had them in Canada, but we know there are people playing from as far away as Australia. So it's really great. The response has been fantastic.
All right, and how can people track Santa this holiday season using social media?
Well, we do it three different ways. So you can do it on, you can track on Facebook, and if you're on Facebook right now, you'd be all those fans who can play the trivia contest. Google+, Twitter, and YouTube. So we use those four ways on social media.
All right, and do you have some statistics from last year and how it's gotten progressively better over the years?
Well, the numbers I rhymed off to you earlier were from last year. I don't have the numbers from the year before, but I do know that last year's numbers were even bigger than the year before. It's been consistently like that as more and more people follow us and understand the NORAD Track Santa program. Putting it on the internet has made it available to people all around the world, and it's just grown and grown since then. And this year the expectation, while we're already higher on Facebook, the expectation is we'll have even more people following from all around the world.
All right, and what have you done so far to set up at NORAD for the big day this year?
Well, every year we set up the NORAD Track Santa Operations Center. I mentioned we have 1,200 volunteers. We have the NORAD Operations Center, and that's the one where we use our satellites and our radars, our fighter jets. That's our maritime warning, aerospace warning, and aerospace control missions are run out of the Operations Center. The NORAD Track Santa Operations Center is strictly set up to track Santa Claus, so we have been doing that. We've been getting all the tables ready, the decorations ready, the screens ready, the phone lines, getting all the computers set up. So it takes a lot of time. In previous years, we were able to do it in roughly a day, and now it's expanded to about 2 days because we're just growing bigger and bigger. I don't know if you recall, but last year, Mrs. Obama was one of the participants. So as more and more people hear about it, they want to participate, and it's been it's been great for us, and it's kind of great for everybody else to see all these volunteers coming in.
Dealing also with Miss Obama coming in as a big representative for the NORAD Track Santa program, are you looking at possible other representatives coming in and working for you this year?
You know, we don't necessarily go out and look for people. It's, at times, something comes across as an idea, and we go, hey, that would be great, maybe we should ask this person. But it's not something we normally do. Back in the, I think it was 2003, 2004, we had Ringo Starr, the former drummer for the Beatles. He did some voiceovers for us. We had Kelly Ripa from Regis and Kelly about 2 years ago do some stuff for us, and she did a promo. So we don't actively look for it all the time, but when the ideas come up, it's great. And in the case last year, if I recall correctly, Mrs. Obama came and wanted to participate, and we just found ways to make that work.
And I do remember last year when she did participate, she actually was calling and taking calls when she was on vacation in Hawaii.
Yeah, that's right. We had the operations center set up, and we're able to forward a certain amount of calls to her in Hawaii so that she could be a participant. From everything we've heard, she really, really had a good time last year.
All right, and how do people at NORAD feel about tracking Santa Claus every year?
Our mission that we do 365 days a year, it is very, very important to us. We can't be wrong in what we're doing. And it's a very serious business. Tracking Santa Claus allows us to be, I don't want to say just as serious, but just as dedicated, but in a far more fun way. And people really enjoy it. The fact that we have so many volunteers who come out at all hours of the day on their days off testifies to the extent that people really enjoy this program. And I know as we're leading up to it and the weeks coming up to it, everybody's talking about it. You get your volunteers in, and people haven't got the message. We're getting phone calls. How do I volunteer? I like this shift. I like that shift. So it's a lot of excitement, a lot of buzz down here, and it's capped off with the events on the 24th. Mm-hmm.
For all of our members at Team Yansu, the YouTube Association of NORAD Track Santa users, without the actual program, we wouldn't have been able to do what we do and get the viewer, some of the viewer base that you guys do. And last year when we got 3,000 viewers, that bumped up a lot of views for you guys. And social media went into a big buzz about that. And working with you guys has been a great privilege for all of us in the YouTube fan community. And it's just been a great experience so far.
Well, that's good to hear. When we were exchanging emails and you were saying how many people were following, that was really great. And you sent us a link where we could look at the video. A lot of people were like, that's impressive. That's pretty good. You're using initiative. And I'm glad we could be part of that and provide something that that you guys are able to use.
All right. Thank you very much, Lieutenant Commander Desmond James. Is there anything else you would like to add?
I just want to say Merry Christmas, everybody, and I hope everybody has a great holiday season this year.
All right. Thank you very much, and I hope all of you watching the show right now enjoy the rest of the tracking day of December 24th, 2011. I'm Gano 136. Back to you.